Hello everyone, this is Vinay and you are watching EduSmart. This video is all about how to write a resume. So I'm going to show you a template of how my resume looks and what to include in a resume so that the interviewer will get impressed and there are high chances that you land your dream job. Now let me show you the quick view of my resume, how you can build this way. Now you can see this resume, right? So now by the end of this video, you will be able to create a resume just like this, which looks very good. You can see the design and all. You know, this is really very pretty, right? Whenever the viewer just views it, he would like this. So this is how we will build a resume for the first look. This is the first thing. So I'm going to show you the built-in model for this so that you can use the same and create your own. After that, we also need to write in a way so that the viewer really like your resume. Let's get started. By the way, I make these videos on free courses, certification, scholarship, placement preparation, internships, etc. If you are looking into any of this data, do not forget to hit the bell icon whenever you subscribe. So let's get started with this. Now this is the site careerapplus.in. I'll put the link in the description box. You just need to click it. Once you click there, you need to click this sign up button and you can use your, you need to write a name, you need to type your email and type your password to sign up if you are a new user, and then you need to activate your account. I already have an account, so I'm going to sign in with my existing account. So I'm going to provide my email address. So once you're done with this, you will need to create a password of your. I have created my own password. If you are interested, you can directly create an account with the your Gmail account itself. You can directly continue with Gmail. That's it. But I didn't do that. So this is how the website looks like. So first of all, you need to click this visual resume. So both experienced as well as freshers can make their own resume here. I'm going to show how a fresher should make a resume. Now click on this fresher. There is a template one. This is the template that I have shown you, right? So this is that template. The first thing is, whatever the name you wanted to display on the resume, you need to fill in here. If you wanted to change that, you cannot change this. If you wanted to change this, you need to go to your dashboard and say that. Let me show you this. When you type the name, when you are logging in, when you are signing up, you can provide the name. That the same name will be displayed here. If you have logged on with your Gmail account, that name will be displayed here. Okay, let me show you on the dashboard. See, this is my account visual resume Vinay's dashboard. So if you wanted to change the name, you can go here and change the name. This is how you cannot change the email address, however. Okay, so this is how you will change the name. Now let us move back and see how to update remaining details. Now here comes the email. Now, once you are done with this, you need to click save and then click next. I'm clicking next. Now, the designation is what that appears just below your name. Now, I have been a CSC student. You can write something because I'm an undergraduate. I'm not passed out, right? So this is why I have written as CSC student. You can write as passionate about data science, passionate about machine learning, software engineering, something like that. You can write anything that you wanted to write. You need to edit here. Coming to the phone number, I didn't disclose my number. You can write your number over here. That's how. You can use your address, Hyderabad, India. About me. I'm a passionate CSC student who is looking to get into the software industry and use all my skills to help the organization in fulfilling the client's requests. So this is basically, I have written for a service-based company. So service-based company, what it typically does is, it will fulfill the requests of their clients, right? So this is why if I am going for a service-based company, I'll be editing this. If I wanted to go for a product-based company, I'll be writing something else here. So do take care that whether you are going for a software service-based company or a product-based company. Depending on that, you need to write this about me. By the way, you should not use the same resume for all the interviews, for all the companies, because based on companies, you need to change the content of your resume. Don't use the same one each and everywhere. So you write something like this. If you are a product based company, you need to write something like, I'm very much passionate about creating things and I'm really interested in thinking logically and I like solving puzzles, etc. If you wanted to write about me, the main thing required for this is communication skills and data structures and algorithms. These are really important for a product based company, data structures and algorithms that we need to write under training, skills, etc. Okay, as of now, about me for a product based company should be thinking logically. I love solving puzzles, something like that. You need to write something like that. Okay, for product based company, for a service based company like TCS, Wipro and all, you need to write that I'm interested in communication skills. I'm very much good at speaking skills and I can solve like this. I'm interested in talking to the clients and etc. That is what a service-based company typically does. So you need to write according to the company that you are going. Now then click save and then click next. That's all. Now coming to the latest degree. That is what BTech CS, right? So what is your average CGPA 8.02? Your institute name. When will you be the passed out? Select June 2021. Your next degree before to this is 10+2, which is HSC. With 98.2% in the college name. When you have passed out from that, then last degree, which is 10th certificate, right? 10th class, 10th SSC, 9.8 CGPA, month and all, your school name, and then click next button. So whatever you fill here will be updated here. You can see this contact, Hyderabad profile, what I have been talking about. See, you can see this BTech CSC JB Institute. This is what I have shown you before, that has been updated here. So once you fill in the details here, that will be updating here. That's simple here. Coming to the major project title. What's your major project? I have done a project on handwritten recognition system. So you need to write a simple description about your project. The project is based on neural network, and ultimate objective of handwritten character recognition is to stimulate the human reading capability so that the computer can read, understand, edit and walk as human do with the text. So this is basically a simple introduction to your project. So once you're done with the project, you need to take a 4 to 5 sentences about the project that are ultimate about the project. That must be the best thing and that must simply best fit your project. Okay. You need to describe everything with this 5 lines, right? So do ensure that you are taking search of 5 lines from your project. This is about major project. Coming to the mini project, image compression using Python. So we can compress the project like images pixel reduction, right? So that is what this image compression using K-means clustering machine learning algorithm. The mini project is a machine learning based image size compression technique using K-means clustering algorithm. The project basically develops a model that can reduce the size of our image by preserving its quality. So with this online, we are having a lot of data everywhere, images and etc, right? So we need to have a reduced size of images without losing the quality. So this is what K-means clustering does, right? You need to write mention that the key points about your mini project here. And then click on next. So here comes the main important part of your resume, which is training one. So I have already provided the Accenture internship program, right? So under training one, I have mentioned here Accenture internship. So the Insider Sherpa is the organization. So it's basically how long did you complete some first to fifth, like that. So what is the date printed on that must be the end date, okay? That is what you need to print. So you need to write something about this training. How did you feel and what is this internship about? I really had an amazing experience with this virtual internship. I have got to know a lot about software industry and how to work with the clients. So this is for a service-based company. So this is why I have written about this Accenture internship program. This is basically, it tells you how to behave with the clients, how to work with the clients and all, right? So if you have completed the Accenture internship program, you will come to know about this, right? So that is what I mentioned in this as training one. You can see here the under the project, mini project, major project and industrial exposure. You can see the Accenture internship program. The training two is Python workshop by IIT Bombay. So it's basically a 15 days one, right? It has started on this date and ended on this date. I have already made a video for that, right? So this is another wonderful training where I have got an amazing opportunity to learn Python programming from scratch, right? We have learned Python using a Canopy, right? That's what we learned here in this workshop. So you can mention such industrial expression. So you need to write in a way that if you can impress your interviewer, you will definitely get hired, okay? Then click save and next. Now coming to the area of interest. So what are you interested in? So what are your hobbies? Hobby 1 is reading. Hobby 2 is social work. Hobby 3. You have added skill. Hobby 3 will be hidden. If you need 3 hobbies, delete skill number 6. So they were asking to skill delete. So if you are adding too many things, it cannot fit into the phone page, right? So for this reason, you can adjust the hobbies and all. If you wanted to have too many hobbies, you need to reduce your skills. Basically, hobbies are 1 or 2. Only do not mention too many hobbies. Only mention 2 or more hobbies. 1 or 2 hobbies and use the space for skills. So basically, this is just a one page resume. This is how it looks at the first view. The first view must be the best view, right? For this reason, this is the best design for this. If you wanted to add some more, you need to use a random resume like samples. Like we had a lot of resumes out on internet. If you see templates, you can use such small template and add it onto the back of this. That's how you will be using. But for the best fit and the best look and the best design, I have brought you this careerapplies.net website. Now click next. You can choose your out of this. You can choose anything that you want. Coming to the area of interest. So computer science engineering, programming and data structures, computer science engineering algorithms. So there are basically a lot of, whenever you say the computer one, like first thing, based on that, you will be getting these all things. If you are a mechanical engineer, you need to choose mechanical engineer here. So mechanical and so that you will get the description about all of that. So programming and data structures, algorithms, databases. These are basically important for a service based company or a product based company. Save and then next. So your comes the skills here. So what is the language? Your C language is my skill. So how do you rate yourself? So I am rating 4 out of 5. Python 4 out of 5. Java 4 out of 5. SQL or SQL 4 out of 5. Machine learning 4 out of 5. Skill like communication skills 5. If you wanted to delete, you can delete. Or if you wanted to add skill, you need to click add skill and add your own skills. Then click save and next. So extracurricular activities. I have won elocution district 2nd 2 times. I have mentioned it here. I have won essay writing 2 times district 1st. I have written this. A member of college NSS club. I am also a member of our college NSS club. So I have mentioned this. So if you wanted to add extra, you can click this add extra and add it onto your resume. And then click save next. So this is how a resume meant for the first page. So this is how it looks for the first page. It's basically very attractive page, rather than what you simply choose on internet, right? There are a lot of resumes templates available. However, I liked this design. This is really good. And the positioning and etc. is really nice. And it's very visible to the viewer. He did not take stress to read out everything. He can simply point out what are his skills, what are his and all etc. So it's simply in one page we have put all the skills together. We can add too many papers, but only the viewer will visit the second page only if he liked the first page, right? So do take care that you have a very good design for the first page so that he will go on to the next page. So this is the only reason where I have brought you this. Do take care of adding another page to this resume. Okay, so that if he is liking this first page, he will definitely move on to the next page and we will look throughout some other skills if you had any. So that's all about how to make a resume to impress your interviewer. So if you like this video, do hit a like button. Also do subscribe.